Okay. Now let us see how to solve this numerical problem. First of all, I think the question is visible for all of you. See the question. A three-phase 50 hertz transmission line has resistance, inductance and capacitance per phase of 10 ohm, 0.1 henry and 0.9 microfarads respectively, and delivers a load of 35 megawatts at 132 kilovolts and 0.8 power factor lag. Determine the efficiency and regulation of the line using nominal T and nominal pi. Okay, so we are not doing third. So this is the exercise problem which you may observe in CL Wadhwa textbook. This is an exercise problem, so you cannot see the solution. You can find only the answers at the last page of your textbook, right? So now we will solve this problem. So I will solve this problem using two different methods. One method is by using ABCD parameters, and another method is by using circuit analysis or by using KVL and KCL relations, right? So here, first of all, let me write what is the data given. The frequency of the supply is given as 50 hertz. And resistance per phase, these are the parameters for one phase given. The resistance per phase is 10 ohms. Similarly, inductance per phase is given as 0.1 henry. And capacitance per phase is given as 0.9 microfarads. 0.9 microfarads. So these are the things which are given in the problem. And in addition to that, we also have receiving end real power, which is PR, okay? And that receiving end real power, which is a three-phase power, and it is given as 35 megawatts. In addition to that, we also have the receiving end voltage. Usually, the receiving end voltage is expressed as a line-to-line voltage. So VR line-to-line is equal to 132 kilovolts, okay? Unless and until it is specified in the numerical problem, we need to consider the given voltage as the line to line voltage. So the receiving end line to line voltage is 132 kilovolts. Similarly, cos phi r is nothing but receiving end power factor, and it is given as 0.8. So this is about all the information that is available in the numerical problem. And from this problem, what is the basic data which we can extract is the receiving end current. Is it right? How can I get the receiving end current? From equating the real power, which is a three-phase real power, which is given in the problem. Please mute your audio. So by equating this three-phase receiving end real power to the expression, so what is that expression? Which is 3 VR phase and IR, which is also expressed in phase, cos phi R. And it is equal to, this is the real power, which is 35 megawatts. Now, from all these, we know cos phi R, which is given as 0.8. We know VR phase, which can be obtained from VR line to line. And what we need to find is IR phase, which is the receiving end current per phase. Now, what is VR phase? If you know receiving end line to line, you can find phase voltage by dividing it with root 3. So phase voltage is equal to line voltage by root 3. So it is 132 kilovolt by root 3. Okay. If you find this value, so this power by 132 by root 3 will gives you, let me find the phase voltage. Phase voltage is 76210.23. So it is 76210.23 volts. This is the receiving end phase voltage. Now, you know VR phase, you know IR phase, you don't know IR phase, you know cos phi R. From this equation, the unknown term is IR phase. Find out that unknown term. So IR phase is equal to 35 megawatt means 35 into 10 power 6 megawatt means 10 power 6 divided with 3 into VR phase is 76210.23 volts into cos fire. Cos fire is 0.8. Right? From this, what is the value of IR phase which you will get? If you evaluate this with the help of calculator, you will get it as 191.35 amperes. This is the receiving end current according to the load power we have found this. Now, let me express this VR phase and IR phase, both are phase, in complex notation. Because when you are finding the sending end voltages or sending end currents or different quantities, we need to know their complex values rather than their magnitudes. Hence, I can write VR phase, okay? It internally says that it is a phase voltage. I am not writing every time. Now, I am considering VR as a reference. So, this will make our numerical problem a simple one. Considering VR as the reference phasor, VR can be now written as 76210.23 at an angle 0 degrees. Similarly, IR can be written as 191.35. What is the angle? So, if it is at 0 degrees, consider if this is VR, which is considered as the reference, so it will be at 0 degrees. And this power factor is of lagging nature. When the power factor is of lagging nature, current lags the voltage. So, if voltage has 0 angle, current will have negative angle. Like this, you will have IR and this angle is phi R. Okay? Now, cos phi R is 0.8. How can you find phi R? Phi R is nothing but cos inverse of 0.8. Cos inverse of 0.8 is -36.86 degrees. So, let me write here, it is -36.86 degrees. So, these two are the complex values of VR and IR which you need to know. Because when solving any numerical problem, it may be short transmission line, it may be on medium transmission line, nominal T, nominal pi, or maybe long transmission line. Whatever may be the transmission line, first you need to find the receiving end voltage as well as the receiving end current in complex notation. Then your problem will be much easier. Right? Now we will start our numerical problem. So, we'll start our numerical problem by considering nominal T first, because it is asked to find the regulation and efficiency of the transmission line using nominal T and nominal pi representations. So, I am considering first nominal T representation. How can you find nominal T representation? So, nominal T is nothing but the impedance is divided into two halves. So, you will have capacitance at the center. So, half impedance at the source side and half impedance at the load side. This is nominal T representation. I don't want to go much detail into this. Okay. So, this is the nominal T representation. Now, I will solve the numerical problem of nominal T using ABCD parameters. Okay, I will solve this numerical problem using two different methods, because you need to understand this, each and every method. What is the difference between these two and what is the simplicity in both the methods? That is the reason why I am solving this numerical problem using two different methods. So, first method is ABCD parameters. So, how can I find the regulation and efficiency by using ABCD parameters? So, first thing which we need to find is sending end voltage, right? Sending end voltage we need to find. So, as we need to find the sending end voltage VS, according to two-port network representation, when we consider this transmission line as a two-port network, the sending end terms and the receiving end terms can be related by using this equation. VS is equal to AVR plus BIR. Similarly, IS is equal to CVR plus DIR. Okay, so this is the standard two-port network equations for any type of transmission lines. Now, from these two equations, how can I find VS and IS? Already we have found VR and IR, and now we need to find A, B, C, D. After finding all these, by substituting in these two equations, we can find VS and IS. Very simple. Now, what is A for nominal pi network? A for nominal pi network is 1 plus YZ by 2. A for nominal pi network is 1 plus YZ by 2. And it is also equal to D. Similarly, what is B value? B value is Z into YZ square by 4. Sorry, Z plus YZ square by 4. This is B value. And what is C value? C value is nothing but Y. What is Y and Z here? Y and Z here are the admittances. Y and Z here are the admittances. Sorry, admittance and impedances. Now what is Z? Z is nothing but R plus J omega L. What is R given in the problem? R given in the problem is 10 ohms and L given in the problem is 0.1 Henry. So R is 10 plus J into 2 pi into 50 into, what is L? L is 0.1. It is omega L. 2 pi F means omega into L, and this is R. And usually the unit for impedance is ohms. Now what is Z value in rectangular form? It is 10 plus J times 31.41 ohms. This is the rectangular form of impedance. If you also convert this into polar form, it comes out to be, please evaluate this with the help of calculators along with me so that you can check whether my answer is correct or not. So the impedance of the transmission line, total impedance, right? The impedance of the transmission line, this is expressed in polar form and this is expressed in rectangular form. And also, what is admittance? Admittance is J omega C, and it is given by J into 2 pi F, 2 pi into 50 into, what is C value given in the problem? It is 0.9 microfarad. So 0.9 into 10 power minus 6. As you have pure as it is a pure imaginary value, I can consider the angle as 90 degrees, and the value of 2 pi into 50 into this value is 2.827 into 10 power minus 4 at an angle 90 degrees. So these are the values of the impedance and admittances for the given data. For the given data, we have found the impedance and admittance of the transmission line. Why we have found the impedance admittance? In order to find ABCD parameters. Why we are finding ABCD parameters? In order to find the sending end voltage and the sending end current. If you know the sending end voltage and sending end current, you can find anything like regulation, efficiency, everything. Now, find A value. How can you find A value? A is given by 1 plus YZ by 2. So 1 plus, what is Y in polar form? It is 2.827 into 10 power minus 4 at an angle 90 degrees. Z, what is Z value in polar form? It is 32.96 at an angle 72.34 degrees. Okay, divided with, it is YZ by 2. Divided with 2, right? Now, what you can do, you can multiply these two magnitudes and then add the angles. When two complex quantities expressed in polar form multiplied together, the resultant value can be obtained by multiplying their magnitudes and adding their angles. So, it comes out to be 1 plus multiplying 2.827 into 10 power minus 4 with 32.96, you will get it as 9.317 into 10 power minus 3. At an angle, by adding these two, 90 plus 72.34 is 162.34 degrees, and you divide with 2. You can directly divide the magnitude with 2. If you directly divide the magnitude with 2, it will become 1 plus 4.658 into 10 power minus 3 at an angle 162.34 degrees. This is A value. But actually, I want to express A value in polar form. Okay. So for doing the problem in a simple way, my suggestion is express VR value, IR value, A, B, C, D, all the values in polar form. Then you can multiply in a simple way. So it is 0.9955. If you evaluate this and convert it into polar form, you will get 0.9955 at an angle 0.0813 degrees. So this is A value. Now find B value. This is A is also equal to D in case of nominal T and nominal pi, right? And what is B value? Formula for B? It is Z plus YZ square by 4. What is Z? Z is 32.96 at an angle 72.34. degrees plus Y. What is Y value? It is 2.827 into 10 power minus 4 at an angle 90 degrees. This is Y, and into you have Z square. This is Z. Z square can be obtained by taking the square for the magnitude and by multiplying 2 with the angle. Okay. So angle must be multiplied with 2. And the magnitude must be squared in order to get the square value, Z square value. If you take the square of 32.96, because you have Z square here, so if you take the square of 32.96, you will get 1086.36 at an angle. If you multiply this angle with 2, it will become 144.68 degrees. So 144.68 degrees. So what is this value? This value is nothing but Y value. Let me write here. What is this value? This value is nothing but Y value. And what is this value? This value is nothing but Z square value. Y into Z square by, you have 4. Let me change the color of the ink. So this is Y value, and the next term is Z square value. Y into Z square by 4. Now evaluate this with the help of calculator. If you evaluate this, I am writing this as it is. So in order to avoid the errors in solving the numerical problem, first solve the term which are complicated. Solve the terms. And if you multiply these two together, you will get one polar form as 0.30711. At an angle, what is this angle? 90 plus 144, it is 234.68 degrees divided with 4, right? Now by dividing 0.30711 with 4, you will get it as 0.0767 at an angle. You have the same angle, 234.68 degrees. And here you have same as it is, so 32.96 at an angle 72.34 degrees. Now adding these two terms together, you will get B value as 32.886 at an angle 72.38 degrees. Okay. So don't bother about these values. If you solve the numerical problem along with me, it will be easier for you. So this is A and D values, A and D values, and this is the value of B. Okay? And let us go to the next one. Next one is C. A and D completed, B also completed, and C. C is simply nothing but Y. And what is Y value? It is 2.827 into 10 power minus 4 at an angle 90 degrees. Now you got A value, D value. Now you got A value, D value, B value, and C value. Substitute this A, B, C, D as well as VR and IR in these two equations. Okay. So these two equations are very, very important. Let me consider these equations as 1 and 2. Substituting these things in A and B. So VS is equal to A VR plus B IR. Substitute VR means by considering the receiving end voltage as well as the receiving end current in per phase quantities, you will get the sending end voltage also as per phase quantity. If you consider VR and IR in line terms, you will get VS also in line. You need to keep this in your mind. Now, what is the A value which we got just now? We got just now the A value as 0.9955 at an angle 0.0813 multiplied with VR value. VR value is 76210.23. As we considered VR as reference, you will get as 0 degrees. Plus, this is the value of A and this is the value of VR. Plus B. What is the value of B? Just now we got it as 32.886 at an angle 72.38 IR. What is IR? It is also in phase 191.35 degrees. Magnitude and angle is minus 36.86 degrees. So if you evaluate this, first by evaluating these two, by multiplying these two, you will get 75,867.28 at an angle 0.0813. Because by adding with zero, the angle will not will remains unchanged. Now it is a 6292.73 at an angle 35.52 degrees. Right? So by subtracting 36.86 from 72.38, you will get 35.52 degrees. Finally, you will get VS in polar form. If you do this in the calculator, it will give you in rectangular form, and converting that into polar form, you can get the magnitude as well as the angle of the sending end voltage. It is given by 81076.34 at an angle 2.66 degrees. This is the sending end voltage which is obtained from ABCD parameters, especially A and B parameters. Now we will move to the next one, which is sending end current. Sending end current IS is equal to CVR plus DIR. What is C value which we got just now? C value is this one. You can see at the top of this slide, you can see the C value. So it is 2.827 into 10 power minus 4 at an angle 90 degrees. This is C into VR. VR is as it is. So 76210.23 at an angle of 0 degrees plus D value is the same as A value. It is 0.9955 at an angle of 0.0813 multiplied with IR. IR is 191.35 at an angle -36.86 degrees. Now, if you evaluate this, the first term, if you take the product of first two terms, you will get it as 21.54 at an angle of 90 degrees, plus second term, if you take the product of the second two terms, second pair of terms, so it is 190.48 at an angle -36.77 degrees. Now, adding these two terms together in the calculator, you will get rectangular form. You will get the answer in rectangular form. Converting that into polar form, you will get the sending end current value as 178.422 at an angle -31.22 degrees. This is the sending end current, which is in amperes. Okay. So in this way, we can find the sending end current as well as the sending end voltage using ABCD parameters. But the thing which you need to keep in your mind is the ABCD parameters must be in your mind. You need to memorize these ABCD parameters. Okay. So to avoid this memorizing process, I gave you another technique for obtaining ABCD parameters, which is a cascaded connection of two port networks. By that, you can easily get these ABCD parameters. Get the formula for ABCD parameters. From that, you can find the sending end voltage and sending end current. Now you got the sending end voltage and sending end current. Let me find four different quantities. First quantity which I want to find is the regulation, voltage regulation. What is voltage regulation formula? As we have seen in our discussion on voltage regulation and efficiency, so percentage voltage regulation is the ratio of percentage voltage regulation is the ratio of the difference between the no load voltage and the full load voltage to the full load receiving end voltage. Let me write the formula for voltage regulation. So percentage voltage regulation, percentage voltage regulation is equal to no load receiving end voltage, no load receiving end voltage VR no load minus VR full load by VR full load into 100. But for this numerical problem, with this method, we cannot find separately VR no load voltage. For this purpose, I gave you another formula which will be useful for any type of transmission line, which is magnitude of Vs by magnitude of A minus magnitude of VR divided with magnitude of VR into 100. You need to consider only the magnitudes of all these things. Now, what is the magnitude of Vs you got? Magnitude of Vs is 81076.34. So I am substituting here 81076.34. And what is the magnitude of A we got? We got the magnitude of A as this one. This is the magnitude of A, which is 0.9955. Let me substitute that magnitude 0.9955. And minus, what is the magnitude of VR, which is the receiving end voltage? It is 76210.23. And it is total divided with, again, 76210.23. If you evaluate this with the help of calculator, first find this term. If you find this term, it comes out to be, let me find this term, it comes out to be 81442.83 minus 76210.23, and it is again divided with 76210.23. So I am doing each and every step in this numerical problem. So please go through this class carefully. You can understand everything related to nominal t and nominal pi, right? Now, what is this value? It comes out to be, if you evaluate this with the help of calculator, it comes out to be 6.86%. When you multiply the answer with 100, you will get a 6.86%. This is the percentage voltage regulation. Similarly, how can you find the efficiency? Let me find the efficiency here itself. Percentage efficiency is the ratio of receiving end power, which is expressed in three phase, and sending end power must also be expressed in three phase multiplied with 100. Okay, we will use this formula here. Whereas if you do not use the method of ABCD matrices, ABCD parameters, you need to find the losses, transmission line losses separately, and then you need to add it to the receiving end power to get the sending end power. But here, as we have found VS, IS, which are the sending end voltage and sending end current, as well as their complex terms, we can find the angle between them also. Is it right? Now let us see that. Let me write VS, IS again here for your understanding. VS is, we got VS as 81076.34 at an angle of 2.66 degrees. Similarly, the sending end current we got as 178.422 at an angle minus 31.22 degrees. If you see the phasor diagram, if you draw a small phasor diagram, considering VR as the reference, so VR is at 0 degrees, sending end voltage has positive angle, it means that it is above VR. So this angle is, example, consider this angle as 2.66 degrees. Similarly, the sending end current has negative angle, it indicates that it must be below VR. So this is IS, so this is VS and this is IS. What is this angle? This angle is 31.22. No need to consider negative, because as we have negative, we draw the phasor below the VR. If we draw the phasor below the reference phasor, it internally indicates, it inherently indicates that the angle for this phasor will be a negative angle. Now, what is the total angle between VS and IS? The total angle between VS and IS is a 2.66 minus, so this angle minus this means find this angle, substitute it as a cos. See, you need to subtract this angle from this angle, so you will get minus of minus plus. Otherwise, from the phasor diagram itself, you can understand that the total angle between VS and IS is the summation of 2.66 and 31.22. Let me find that. So cos phi s is nothing but cos of, what is phi s? It is a 2.66 plus 31.22. So the total angle is 33.88. This is the total angle. So cos of 33.88 degrees. This is cos phi s, which is the sending end power factor. If you evaluate this, it comes out to be 0.83 lag. Why it is lag? Because it is lagging with respect to IS, is lagging with respect to VS. Now find sending end power in three phase. Total three phase sending end power. What is total three-phase sending end power? It is three times sending end voltage, which is expressed in phase, and multiplied with sending end current, which is also expressed in phase, multiplied with cos phi s. Okay, it is like three V-phase, I-phase, cos phi. But here we have sending end voltage, sending end current, and sending end power factor, because the power is sending end power. Right? So this is the PS. Now let us find the efficiency directly, or if you evaluate this by substituting VS, IS, cos phi s, you may get it as 43.39 megawatts. By substituting the sending end power and receiving end power here, the receiving end power is 35 megawatts. So 35 into 10 power 6 divided with, if you want to substitute, you can substitute here, 3 into what is VS phase, it is 81076.34 multiplied with what is the current, it is 178.422, and what is the power factor, it is a cos of the angle is 33.88 degrees. So by doing all, by substituting all this and multiplying this with 100, this is the real power receiving end power 3 phase, and this is the sending end power 3 phase using this formula. Now you will get this, you will get the efficiency as 97.14%. This is the percentage efficiency. So we have found four different parameters for nominal T network. One is the percentage voltage regulation. One is the percentage voltage regulation, which is 6.86%. And the second one is sending end power factor, which is cos phi s. Actually, this sending end power factor as well as sending end power are not asked in the problem, but I am giving you when it is asked in the problem, you need to find in this way. Okay. So percentage voltage regulation, sending end power factor, as well as sending end power. This is the third one. And the fourth one we have found is efficiency. Okay. So these are the four things. Pi. So nominal pi is the second numerical problem. Nominal pi. So I am considering the circuit here. I am using KVL as well as KCL relations to find the sending end voltage as well as the sending end current here. So this is the nominal pi representation. What is this? This is completely Z. This is completely Z. And what is this? This is Y by 2 and this is Y by 2. Let me change the color of the ink. So this is the sending end voltage Vs and this is the sending end current Is, and this is the receiving end current Ir, and this is the receiving end voltage Vr. Now what is this current? I am considering this capacitance as C2 and I am considering this capacitance as C1, or I can consider this as C1, this as C2, whatever it may be, it depends upon your convenience. So I am assuming this current as IC1 and I am assuming this current as IC2. Now if you apply KCL at this point, it will be considered as IL. So IL is the summation of these two currents. So IL is equal to IC1 plus IR. Similarly, IS is the summation of two currents. One is IL and IC2. And as the sending end side, sending end source, as well as this capacitance C2, both are in parallel. So the voltage across C2, which is VC2, is VS. Similarly, the voltage across C1, which is VC1, is same as VR. Now, let me write the VR and IR values, which we have found from the previous problem. These are the same values, whatever may be the type of representation, whether it is nominal T or nominal pi, the receiving end voltage and the receiving end current will not change because they depends upon the load, not the transmission line. So I can consider VR as 76210.23 at an angle of 0 degrees. Similarly, IR, which is the receiving end current, IR as 191.35 at an angle minus 36.86 degrees. I am using the same values because the receiving end terms are independent of the type of representation, whether it may be nominal T or nominal pi. Now let us find the VC1 What is VC1? It is the voltage across C1. What is this value? It is equal to VR, because the receiving end voltage as well as the capacitance both are connected in parallel. Now what is VR? Let me write again. So 76210.23 at an angle 0 is VC1. From the capacitor, from the voltage across the capacitor, how can I find the current flowing through capacitor? IC1 is nothing but current flowing through the capacitor C1, whereas VC1 is nothing but the voltage across the capacitor C1. Please mute your audio. IC1 is nothing but current flowing through the capacitor C1, whereas VC1 is nothing but the voltage across the capacitor C1. If you know the voltage across the capacitor as well as its admittance, you can find the current by using the formula. What is the formula which we can use? It is VC1 into Y by 2, because Y by 2 is the admittance. VC1 is the voltage. As we have found just now VC1 as this value, substitute that value, 76210.23 at an angle 0 degrees multiplied with Y by 2. It is a pure capacitor, so you will get the angle as 90 degrees. Now what is the magnitude? Magnitude is 2.827 into 10 power minus 4 divided with 2. And the angle is 90 degrees. This is Y by 2. Now it is equal to, you can take the by 2 for magnitude. Okay. Now if you evaluate this, if you calculate this, you need to multiply the magnitudes and add the angles. If you add the angles, you will get 90 degrees. If you multiply the magnitudes, you will get the answer as 10.7723 at an angle 90 degrees. What is this value? This is the value of IC1, which is the current flowing through the capacitor C1. The capacitor C1 is connected at the load side. And what is its value? It is half of the total capacitance, C by 2. That is the reason why we have taken Y by 2, which is J omega C by 2. Now, what is IL? IL is the summation of, if you apply KCL at this point, it is the summation of two currents. What are the two currents? IR and IC1. What is IR value? Here you have IR value, which is 191.35 at an angle minus 36.86 degrees plus, what is IC1 value? It is 10.7723 at an angle of 90 degrees. So this is IC1 value and this is IR value. Adding these two, you will get the answer as 185. So when you do anything in the calculator, it by default it will give the answer in rectangular form. You need to convert the answer in polar form. Okay, so the value of IL is 185.05 at an angle of minus 34.19 degrees. So this is IL value. From this, how can I find VS value? VS is the voltage in between these two terminals. VC1 is the voltage. VC1 or VR is the voltage in between these two terminals. If you apply KVL for this loop, you will get this voltage, which is VS, as the summation of the voltage across this capacitance plus the drop across this branch. What is the drop across this branch? It is IL times Z. So VS can be given by, from this circuit, the VS can be given by applying KVL. You can get this as VR plus IL into Z. Okay, I have explained everything in the modeling of medium transmission line using nominal pi method. Now, what is VR value? VR value we have found here itself already. So 76210.23 at an angle 0 degrees. This is VR value plus What is IL value? IL is just now we have found, it is 185.08 at an angle minus 34.19 degrees multiplied with Z. What is Z value? Z is 32.96 at an angle 72.34 degrees. 32.96 at an angle 72.34 degrees. Now, substituting these two, means multiplying these two together, you will get the answer for VS as 81095.03 at an angle 2.66 degrees. At an angle 2.6 degrees. This is the sending end voltage which we have found using the concept of KVL and KCL of circuit analysis. So nominal pi, here we have applied or we have solved the numerical problem to find sending end voltage and sending end current using the mathematical relations like mathematical laws like KVL and KCL. Okay, so we got this equation by KCL and we got this equation by KVL, is it right? And some other formula. This is the sending end voltage. Now, how can I find the sending end current? If you apply KCL at this point, sending end current is the summation of these two currents, IL and IC2. IL value is already found. What we need to find is IC2. IC2 is nothing but the voltage across this capacitor multiplied with admittance of this capacitor. What is the admittance of this capacitor? Y by 2. So, IC2 is nothing but the voltage across the capacitor C2 is VS, because VS is the same as VC1. It is also equal to VC2. So, actually, in place of VS, what we must get? In place of VS, we must get VC2. In place of VS, we must get VC2. So, VC2 into Y by 2, but as VC2 is same as VS, I can multiply VS with Y by 2. What is VS we got? We got VS as 81095.03 at an angle of 2.66 degrees. This is the sending end voltage multiplied with Y by 2. Y by 2 is just now we have written here. So, it is J omega C by 2. J omega C value is 2.827 into 10 power minus 4 by 2. The angle is 90 degrees. At an angle 90 degrees. So, add the total angle. It is 90 degrees and it is 2.66. So, the total angle is 92.66 degrees. And how can you get the magnitude? Multiply this magnitude with this magnitude, you will get the answer as 11.462. So this is IC2 value, but I don't need IC2 value. What I need is IS value. What is IS? IS is nothing but IL plus IC2. Now substitute IL value. IL value is here and IC2 is here. Substitute these two values, you will get IS value. So, what is IL value? It is 185.08 at an angle minus 34.19 degrees plus IC2 value is 11.462 at an angle 92.66 degrees. By adding these two, this is IL value and this is IC2 value. By adding these two, you will get IS value. Find IS value using calculator. So, by doing this with the help of calculator, you will get the answer in rectangular form. Convert that in polar form, you will get the answer as 178.44 at an angle minus 31.24 degrees. Minus 31.24 degrees. So this is the value of sending end current. This is the value of sending end current, and this is the value of sending end voltage, which we obtained by using KVL, KCL, and Ohm's law for AC circuits. If you observe, if you see the sending end voltage and sending end current values for nominal T by applying ABCD parameters, you can check the answers. It is 81076.34 at an angle 2.66 degrees. If you check the answer here, you will also get 2.66 degrees, but this is a little bit higher. Yes, a little bit higher, and this value is almost same IS value. Let me check the IS value, which we have found using ABCD parameters. See here, it is 178.42 at an angle minus 31.22. What is this value? 178.44 at an angle minus 31.24. So we will get almost same values of sending end and sending end current and sending end voltage. Either you apply ABCD parameters or you apply KVL and KCL things. So this is the beauty of transmission lines, as well as this is the beauty of ABCD parameters. No need to apply KVL and KCL. You just need to find ABCD values to find the sending end voltage and sending end current. Now, what is VS value? Let me write here 81095.03 at an angle of 2.66 degrees, and IS is equal to 178.44 at an angle of minus 31.24 degrees. Now find the percentage regulation again. Percentage voltage regulation, we know this from our circuit, we know this from our generalized formula. So percentage voltage regulation, percentage voltage regulation is given by magnitude of VS by magnitude of A minus magnitude of VR divided with magnitude of VR into 100. We need to know one thing. For nominal T as well as nominal pi, the A value remains the same. Nominal T and nominal pi representation, in both the representations, A value is the same, which is 1 plus YZ by 2. Right? So that is the reason why I have not found A value again, because for nominal T and nominal pi, A value is same. Now substitute in this expression. What is magnitude of VS? It is 81095.03 divided with what is magnitude of A? Magnitude of A is 0.9955. So 0.9955 minus what is magnitude of VR? Just now we have seen it as it is same for everything. So it is 76210.23. It is the magnitude, right? And it again you will get 76210.23. You need to multiply with 100 in order to get the percentage voltage regulation. So you will get 6.89%. See, by using with ABCD parameters, we got the regulation as 6.86%. We got the same value, almost same value. It is with KVL and KCL. So percentage voltage regulation is 6.89%. Similarly, what is percentage efficiency? Percentage efficiency is receiving end power by sending end power. So what is receiving end power? 35 megawatts. So 35 into 10 power 6 divided with sending end power is 3 VS phase. This is VS phase. So 81095.03 into IS phase, it is 178.44 into cos of the angle between these two. So it is 2.66 plus 31.24. If you find this, if you evaluate this, you will get the answer as 97.13%. So this is the percentage efficiency. Okay. So I have not found the sending end power factor. What is sending end power factor? Cos phi s is nothing but cos of the angle between Vs and phi s. It is 2.66 plus 31.24. Okay, you will get minus of minus plus. So find this value, you will get the sending end power factor. Similarly, how can you find the sending end power? Find this denominator value, which is 3 Vs Is cos phi s. Okay, so I have not done these two because these two are same, almost same as the previous problem. So in this way you can find all the four parameters for nominal t and nominal pi. In nominal t we have found all these four parameters. What are the four parameters we have found? One is the sending end power factor, and the second one is sending end power, third one is a percentage voltage regulation, and the fourth one is percentage efficiency. We have found all these things by using just ABCD parameters and the standard two-port network equations. And for nominal pi method, I have applied the second another method, which is KVL and KCL. So by using all these, we again found cos phi s, PS, percentage voltage regulation, and percentage efficiency using KVL, KCL and Ohm's law for AC circuits. So these are the two methods in order to find all the four parameters or all the four quantities. Okay. I hope with this numerical problem you can understand how to solve the numerical problems on medium transmission line using nominal